Okay.
Well, hey there, this is Ricky J. Taylor, and I'm joined tonight at Gallagher Guitars for the Gallagher Unplugged music series, joined by the incomparable Jim Wood and Baily Johnstone. He's incomparable too. And so we're going to do some original songs for you tonight, and I think everything's original we're going to do. So without further ado, let's launch into a song called My Blue Friends. I wrote this on the front porch way down in Alabama. Not particularly personal song, but it just sort of came to me in a Hank Williams sort of way, and I was absorbing all the stimulus from that evening, and I just wrote it all into a song. So you'll hear comment about a train and a candle and a whippoorwill, all that stuff was going on, and it just got absorbed into the song. It's a good thing the neighbor's cats weren't doing what they do sometimes. So. It's got My Blue Friends.
Night with my blue.
studio audience. I think I could have went ahead and put the capo on, but no.
It's where they get to see the process.
Yeah. Behind the scenes process. Putting on capo. And thank you to Gallagher Guitars for letting me play a couple of fine instruments tonight. I've already worked out with Jim. He's going to create a distraction a little bit later. I'm sneaking out the front door with this. So this song deals with a little issue of being divided. We seem to be so polarized these days, and everybody's just taking sides. And it just occurred to me that we allow ourselves to be defined by things that really don't matter. And once you identify with all those trivialities, you put yourself in a position to be divided. So this song is called Weights and Measures, but it's inspired by that idea, by things that you know, the colors or shapes or ages, all these sort of things. It didn't really matter at the end of the day. There's something much bigger than that. So here you go.
Thank you. Let it go and set your body free. There's no you, there's no me. Perfection we seek, never find. Do we seek the one love divine? Color, shapes, and numbers, weights and measures, waiting on your mind.
Slogan for tonight.
Okay.
Considering my last name and the guitar. We could say Taylor plays Gallagher's. you can publish that, right?
There we go.
I was too busy cutting up, putting the capo on the wrong fret, and Jim's over here going, second fret.
I got you back.
I don't know what I'd do without you. Play out of key a lot, that's for sure. I was raised in a poor family. My mom and dad were from Central Alabama. I just learned actually a couple of years ago that my mom was actually a sharecropper. Her family was.
I thought you were going to say you just learned a couple of years ago how to read and write.
Well, I mean, my dad talks about the first time they had an electric light bulb in the house, you know. But anyway, the point of all that is that, you know, they learned to work hard. They had to. And they taught me and my siblings the same thing, working hard. And so everything I have is essentially what I work for. And I say all that because there have been times when I'd see somebody on the side of the road or looking like what people would oftentimes call a bum. And it occurred to me, wait a minute, things can happen and they're beyond your control. You could be anybody in this world and then put in that situation with something that you had literally no control over. So my heart sort of softened and gave birth to this song about someone like that. Lost a child and ended up being completely off the grid, unable to function. And I had an experience walking across the street near my house one time. Somebody pulls by and yells at me, "Get a job, you homeless piece of so and so." And I thought, well, there you go. You know, you can't really judge unless you really get to know somebody. This is called "I Move On." Traffic here is murder. It never seems to end. I lie awake and wonder where they all begin. Everyone's in a hurry, they got some place to be. I guess they're looking for the road to freedom. The sun now comes in the morning, I'm thinking about my home. My daddy's hands, a young boy's plans, and the cotton's on. Sings a
songs and leaving. I know it won't be long. And on a Sunday morning, I move on. Everything that I have is just what I have on. Every need that I had is gone. I wake up on the sidewalk between two fine hotels. Could be that I'm dreaming, but I can't tell.
They would actually give me an award if I was able to recite them all. But this is called Now Comes Ever.
Oh, and just for my engineer, John Purvis' little boy, Ever.
Oh, okay. I thought it was more philosophical than that.
Well, it has multiple.
Yeah, and Jim just taught himself this song just moments before we started rolling here. So.
Thank you.
eye is on one of these circular disc-like objects, relics from the past. This one's called A Journey to Here, and this one's the new one that we just finished, called The Edge of Light. We never actually got to do a CD release gig on that one when everything came to a grinding halt. Yeah. And I'd like to say also a shout out to the rest of the Live Roots Ensemble is traditionally the band that I perform with. These guys are part of that. We pared it down because of obvious reasons of concern and safety tonight, but just, hey you guys, next time I hope we can all be together and do this. This song is called The Portrait, and no real setup, just imagine a bedroom with a table beside it and a photograph of a woman on the table. Thank you. mean it. That's actually the only relevant part of the song.
Yeah. I'm ready for the things that I don't know. Whatever I become, whatever comes of me, where trying takes me, so shall I go.
This is about the search for enlightenment. We always seem to be scratching and clawing our way through life, trying to make sense out of everything. And I was given reason to think of this Bible verse. In fact, Jim said, "Hey, one night, your songs remind me of a Bible verse." And he came out and said, quoted this Bible verse. And interestingly, another completely different friend from a different state said exactly the same thing, pointed to the exact same verse in the Bible. And so I wrote a song called Corinthians Mine.
Searching in darkness, not knowing sun from rain, longing for what's always out of sight.
Baily, Johnstone.